Hello, what I'm going to do today is brush out some high float fibers for you. I've been asked quite a few times, how do you brush out the high float fibers? Well, there's an easy way of doing it, and I'm doing it, I do the whole thing usually at one time. What I've got is a piece of masonite. It's easier to use masonite because it's a smooth surface and it'll take a lot of abuse. And it's at an angle. And what I have is a drawer pulled out of a desk and I have it as an angle. Or you can put it on any table with an angle. Here's some high float fiber. This is a caddis tan. I'm going to brush out one side and show you how it's done. Well, this is how I hold it up here. Put it in my hand around the index finger and in the middle finger, and I roll over and the thumb pushes it. Let's do it again. In my hand, around the first finger to the middle finger, like here. Then I roll it over and my thumb pushes on it. This keeps it from being pulling the fibers out with your brush. This is a simple dog brush. It's a very soft wire dog brush. Hard tined dog brushes will rip through it. What I'm going to do, I'm gently stroke it down from the very top. Go on one side, go on this side, gently stroke it down. So at the bottom, and work up. I'm going to flip it over and do the back side. Keep on doing this. See how it's fluffed up? Now we still have a few ratty things in here. You can still use the dog brush and just work on the way down toward the very base. Now another thing you can do is go to, if you people know who are carders, is this is a very basic cart. It's a used one, and I want a used one because the tines have been, they're not as stiff as a new one. The new ones have such stiff tines, it'll rip this. But the used ones have softer tines, they're more flexible in here. What I do is do this. I go from the top and I fluff it down. This gets rid of all the knots. You can see some little knots in here. This gets rid of all the knots. I'm going to flip it over. You can probably go to a friend that has a carder or something, or a wool shop, or has a, you can start to get a used carder or a soft one. And that's it. It's fluffed up. Now, on the other side, if I want to do the back side, I do the same thing again. I'll brush it out. I'm using my dog brush because the tines are very, very flexible. It doesn't rip it. There's not a lot of waste. It doesn't take much time at all to really do it. Flip it over and do it again on the back side. Now, again, I'm going to take my used carder. You can feel it tug a little bit. You pull some of it out. You're pulling the knots. There. Fluffed up. There's the knots. You can take the knots if you really wanted to. Save it. Cut it up. And you put it in your dubbing. This is a completely fluffed out. You see how poofy it is at the bottom? And when you use some of it here, you can go back in and fluff it some more. It's completely done. In a matter of a few minutes. That's how you brush out a high float fiber.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.